Welcome to episode 71 of My Views Extended. I'm your host, Nadia, and thank you so much for joining me this week. Before I continue, I just want to get some the regular business out of the way. You can listen to My Views Extended at nadiajanelle.com. That's my blog, where the audio version will always be if it's nowhere else. You can also listen to this podcast on my YouTube channel. My YouTube channel name is Nadia Janella. The audio version is also available on iTunes and Stitcher and VidMe, which is another video platform. And of course, as always, I will ask that if you like what you hear, all of your shares on social media, sending it through a text, giving a like, a rating, or leaving a comment in the comment section. I love to interact, and so please don't feel weird about interacting. I do love to hear comments, as long as you're, of course, respectful. Yeah, so any shares that you can give are very much appreciated. Like I said, if you have any questions or concerns, you can contact me on any of those platforms, or you can message me privately at myviewsextended@gmail.com, and I will get back to you as soon as possible. So yeah, I will leave all those links in the show notes and description area. This week, I just wanted to, it's not going to be a full podcast, but I didn't want to let another week pass. I dislike letting time pass. Usually if time passes, it's just because I just need a break. And unfortunately, the last week passed because I just ran out of time. I just wanted to just come in and see how everybody's doing and just say what's been going on, which hasn't been much. I've just been working. I've been kind of suffering. I am dramatic, but I'm only dramatic when it comes to certain things. And those certain things are the summer heat and skunks. I'm so glad summer is here because even though I'm not a fan of summer, my patio garden is growing. It was a little late because I did have to restart some things in my patio garden because I just let things that were the seedlings kind of die and they got funguses and I just wasn't being proactive in getting them planted. So I had to restart a few things, but things are transplanted. Things are going great. So I do love the fact that I can grow things on my patio balcony garden. So I do appreciate that about summer. You know, of course, strawberries, cherries are coming up. Although I was talking to my sister the other day and it was like, and I guess some of her and her coworkers were talking about, you know, you'll want to eat really good fresh food and you want to, and they say, you know, you should eat in season, and then things like strawberries and cherries are in season, but they're so expensive. And I know that for local strawberries, local cherries, local corn, all those things, they're very short seasons. But why are cherries, and you know, if you know anything about me, cherries are like my number one favorite fruit. Why are cherries $7.99 a pound, $8.99 a pound? You go to some supermarkets out here in BC, in the Vancouver area, all over. These people have the nerve to have cherries for local cherries for $11. They're not out yet. So far, I've only seen California strawberries. But anyway, they have the strawberries $11.99 a pound. I'm like, excuse me? It's local, supposed to be local within a whatever amount of kilometers. Why are these things so expensive? Same with strawberries. Or the strawberries are a good price, but by the time they get shipped here, they're like, if you don't eat them within 24 hours, they're going to be no good. Because, you know, strawberries have a very short life span once they're picked. So I'm like, anyway, I forgot what I was having a little tangent about, but let's bring it back to the positive. I love the few things that I like about summer are that I can enjoy the fruits of my labor. Not that I'm laboring over a huge garden plot, but yeah, I'm growing, let's see, some marigolds to help with the bugs, keep the bugs away, two different kinds of lettuces, chives, herbs, which I actually have to probably go back and redo some herbs. I'll probably end up having to buy the seedlings, not start from the seed because it's kind of late in the season. Tomatoes are started, transplanted some house plants, got my pepper plant transplanted. Anyway, I'm glad about that. And I think I've said this before, but the good thing, like back in Ontario when it was hot, like if you don't have central air conditioning back in Ontario, thank God we had central air, but if you don't have central air, you're kind of screwed because if it's like, say, 32 degrees with a Humidex making it feel like 40 or 42 degrees, you're done. Because But when nighttime hits and the sun goes down, you're lucky if it drops down 2 or 3 degrees some days. Whereas out here, it can be, I think it reached 32 times last week. I think this week is supposed to be a quite a bit cooler, but warm, but cooler. But last week and over the weekend, it reached 30 degrees, I think, two times. By the time about between 6 and 7, the temperature drops dramatically. You can pop open your window. You know, your fans are going, like if you have ceiling fans or whatever, because most people out here don't have central air or air conditioners because the seasons used to be so short, not so much anymore. But yeah, as long as, you know, your fans are going all day, you whip open your windows and your patio doors, and that cool air lets you stay cool all night long, and you get some relief. You're not stifling all day and stifling all night. And then by about 2-ish, it starts to warm up again in the daytime, and then it reaches its high around 3 o'clock. So it's warm. But you're like, okay, if I can get through the daytime, you know it's going to cool off at nighttime. So I don't know. I forgot what I was saying again. See, when I go off on a tangent when I don't have things written down, this is what happens. But anyway, I'm just going to go with it because I wanted to come back this week. Really, I've been working on a few recipes. Yeah, just chugging along every day. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I think last time I was talking about iZombie, I thought it was done. It wasn't done. When I bulk watch TV shows, Netflix shows, whatever, I don't really pay attention. I just like let it keep playing and playing and playing, and I thought that it was done. But apparently it's only like halfway through the season. Oops. So I'm going to let it build up. I don't know if I'll wait till the end of the season, but maybe I'll let it build up for another 4 to 6 episodes before I go ahead and watch it again. Yesterday or Sunday was really cool. It was not cool. I tested a recipe and what else did I do? And then I did nothing. It was great. And I realized it was like around 8 o'clock and I was starting to get myself ready for Monday. And I was like, after like 10:30 when I was done, I just lounged around all day and I did not. And I realized at that 8:30-ish time, I didn't feel guilty. And I was like, you managed to do nothing, sit on your butt, drink iced tea or lemon something, whatever drink it was, ate, and you did nothing. And I didn't feel guilty. And that is a huge, huge thing for me. I am so proud of myself. Some people are like, what are you talking about? That's madness. It was so good. Because if you're a person like me who, if you don't, even on your day off, you feel like you have to be productive on your day off. And if you can do nothing, or what you consider nothing, not much, and you don't feel guilty, that is a huge, huge step and a big deal. And I'm just so proud of myself. Are you one of those people? Let me know. Are you one of those people who you can very easily do nothing and you're enjoying it and you've never had a problem? Or are you one of those people who you always have to be productive, even on your day off? You have to have a structured day off. And if you do nothing, you feel guilty. And it's like, and then by the time your day off is done, you're so stressed out about doing nothing that you might as well not have had a day off because you're not relaxed and you're just stressing about all that you have to do. It was a great Sunday. It was great. I was so proud of myself. And then, of course, plus it being super hot out, it was, you know, it was hot. I'm sure that helped. That helped because it's like, if I get up and do something, I'm going to be sweating buckets in 5 minutes flat because I'm a sweaty girl. I'm a sweaty woman. I'm not doing that nonsense of mist and what are women's, I get misty, I get dewy, my behind. I sweat like a man. It's disgusting. And that's how it is, because that's real. I'm not ashamed of it. I'm sweaty. Obviously, not in the wintertime when it's cold, but when it's hot, you'll know that I'm hot because I sweat, and that's okay. Anyway, so yeah, that is pretty much it. There's just working. Oh, I forgot. I'm trying to, because I'm not a person, I'm going to be honest, I love being a creator, but I'm not one of those creators who has to be in front of the camera. And if you'll notice for through any of my videos and things, and even my social media, like a lot of times people, like half of their social media is a selfie of them, and that's fine. I don't think I look bad. I'm not embarrassed about my looks. But I just am not a person who likes to have selfies, and every single video that I have out, it doesn't need to be on my face. Like, you'll see me maybe at the start of a video introducing my video, and then I, from that point on, past the introduction, we're focusing on whatever I'm doing, whether it's a DIY project, whether it's food, baking, whatever it is, let's focus on the product, focus on the thing. I'm not a person. I just, that's just not my nature. I don't mind, obviously, people focusing on my voice, but I'm just not in front of the camera type. of person. And I think that's okay because, you know, like I said, I'm the product or the thing that I'm talking about is the focus and should be the focus in my personal opinion of what I'm doing for my work. So anyway, all that said, I am going to try to do, because I'm still trying to figure out that the Instagram Live, there's Instagram Live, and then on Instagram there's also like this, what do you call it, it's like you can do like videos instead of a picture, you do like a short little video and you can put up a video as a post. And then they also, like I said, they have a live feature, because I do listen to watch a lot of people on Instagram. A lot of YouTubers, I watch them on Instagram when they have their live feeds. And I guess according to them, they would do like a live stream, which is Instagram. It's like an hour before it cuts you off. And they added a save feature so you can actually save your Instagram live and then so people can replay it later. Or if you just want to have it for whatever reason. So I'm kind of toying with that idea of maybe one of these days, like on a Saturday or Sunday, or even maybe, for example, like doing a really quick thing on Instagram and doing a save, a quick recipe or a quick something, beverage or something like that. I don't know, but we'll see, because of course with that, then it's going to have to be somewhat focused on me. But yeah, I don't know. I'm just uncomfortable. Is anybody else uncomfortable in front of the camera? Like, you do it because it's a necessity of the creative process. Because sometimes you see a lot of people's video and they're literally, they have the camera in their face the entire time, like right up in their face, and they're looking at the video, and I know they want to look at the video so it looks like they're talking to you. I mean, which they are, but obviously talking to you at a later date. But I don't know. There's something that's just not me. Like I said before, there's nothing wrong. Some people that's just their personality. They like the camera in their face. They like it focused on them, and that's cool. But that has never been my personality. It just simply isn't me. I like to, if I'm creating something, whether it's food wise, DIY wise, you know, my garden series that I have going on for 2017, whatever it is, I just want to focus on that. But anyway, I don't know. I don't know if I'm ever going to be completely comfortable, like how people have themselves focused the entire time along with what they're doing. That wouldn't be me. I wouldn't be being true to myself. So, but anyway, I do want to try something like the Instagram and just talking to people. It's not like really talking, like I'll be talking and then you can put in questions as I'm going live, and you know, you can ask questions and I'll answer it live. But I don't know, maybe. I know YouTube has a live feature and Facebook has a live feature, just to bring a little more of me outside of my videos to, I don't know, I guess share who I am, who is Nadia, and any questions that you can ask live. So, well, not any, but some questions that can be asked and that I'll answer most of them. Who knows? Anyway, I also wanted to add before I forget that I'm not saying forever, but for the time being, I'm probably not going to be talking about any highly charged things that are going on in the news around the world when it comes to shootings, whether through, you know, civilian police, bombings. I made the decision, I think, a couple weeks ago that, let me just shut my window here because the traffic sounds are loud and they're just going to get worse. But anyway, I made the decision to not even click on any of the videos. You know, like I watch, you know, on my social media, there's videos about this shooting, this person getting beat up by the police and this and that. And I'm giving myself a break. I don't know how long it's going to be. I don't know if it's going to be for another month. I don't know if it's going to be months. I don't know, year. I don't know, forever. Obviously, if I'm called, if I feel like I'm supposed to say something, if it's on my mind and I feel like I have to say something, I will. But I think for my own mental well-being, to keep my blood pressure down. I don't have blood pressure problems, but I don't want to get them. I've, you know, made the effort to not click on any videos to see it. I feel enraged. I feel angry when I see things happening, and it saddens me. And from where I am, I can't do anything. It's heartbreaking. And so I'm making the decision to not say anything for now. I'm aware of what's going on. I'm not going to put my head under the sand by any means. I'm aware of what's going on. I will read stories, but I'm not going to, I guess I may sound dramatic, I'm not going to disturb my spirit by watching people dying, by watching people getting beaten up, by seeing towers burn down. So I probably won't be talking about that for the time being on this podcast or having things or saying writing things on social media. I may occasionally maybe retweet something or like a story. It's just not healthy to keep. I can't keep clicking and getting angry and then what? So yeah, I just wanted to also add that little update to today's podcast. This week, I did want to stick with one thing, quote of the week this week, and I chose it because it is from L.M. Montgomery from Anne's House of Dreams. I love the Anne of Green Gables book series and the movie and the television series and all that. I don't know about the new version that they have out. I don't know if it's finished or if it's in production or if it's coming soon, but they do have a new version of Anne of Green Gables. But I loved it when I was growing up. Pretty sure I probably have some books somewhere in a box somewhere. But yeah, this week's quote, all in all, it was never to be forgotten summer, one of those summers which come seldom into any life, but leave a rich heritage of beautiful memories in their going. One of those summers which, in a fortunate combination of delightful weather, delightful friends, and delightful doing, come as near to perfection as anything can come in this world. L.M. Montgomery, Anne's House of Dreams. I actually chose that. Well, first of all, it's beautiful. And I chose it because I am not a summer person. Every summer that passes, I'm trying to find more things that are good about summer, that are positive about summer. I don't know if, unless I all of a sudden become one of those people who are always cold throughout the year, I don't know how I'm going to love it. I mean, who likes being hot and sweaty and sticky and it makes you tired? So I wanted to find something positive about summer. And if you allow it, you can have beautiful memories. I mean, you have early mornings, you have late nights, obviously the same 24 hours, but the sunlight is just longer, which means more time to do things, whether it's by yourself, whether it's with friends, whether it's with your children. You know, summer holidays for most people, most like some schools are the summer holidays are shorter, but most schools that I know about in North America anyways have the extended 3 month, 2.5, 3 month summer break with exceptions. And it's just, you know, I guess if you look at it from the standpoint of a child or the standpoint of a parent who is able to find a way to spend more time, do more things, more activities, you know, even if it's just lazing around, if it's having a beach day, having a picnic day, going camping, you know, there are just so many things that you can find. And I guess it goes along with, and I'll just pull this right into it, what I'm grateful for this past week. I guess I'm grateful for being able to find the positive in something that I'm not particularly fond of, which is the summer heat. But I'm grateful for the growing season for my patio garden. I'm grateful for the longer extended amount of light. So, you know, if I do want to go farther into the city, say if I want to go into Stanley Park, I don't have to necessarily rush back and worry about being out on the street at when it's pitch dark at 5:30. I can take my time and have plenty of time to enjoy the outdoors and still get home where it's, you know, not dark and it's safe. I'm just making an effort to find things that are beautiful and enjoyable about the summer season. Let me know what you're grateful for and if there's anything that you pulled from that quote. And if you are a summer person, because I know probably most people are, there are a few grumpies like me, grumpy people who we are not fans of the summer, but I think most people do enjoy the summertime and the heat. So let me know if what you can find that's great in the summer, that you is enjoyable about the summer, that's good about the summer. And if you are a summer lover, heat lover, let me know what your favorite thing, or at least one of your favorite things, are about the summer season. Thank you for tuning in to episode 71 of My Views Extended. I would love to hear feedback and comments of what you think of this podcast and the topics, loose that they were this week. If you have any questions or concerns, please contact me on any of my social media or at myviewsextended@gmail.com. And as always, I will leave links to all social media sites in the show notes and description areas. And please drop your questions or opinions respectfully in the comment section. As more listening platforms are added or changed, I will let you know. Until next time, this is Nadia.
Yeah. Hey, but on the real though, what's up? I slapped this song on everything I love, boy. My man. You never seen basketball wives at all.
What?
Cool. And you don't think green yards was fly at all.
No, you don't, no, you don't, no, you don't.
Still, it's like you from the same block, boys. What's on?
It's like you from the hood, but you're not, though.
And you just realized that your brain got more to show.